In this tutorial, we are going to solve some mixture word problems, also known as weighted averages, by using the seesaw method. So let's review the three different scenarios you can have when given a mixture word problem. So here's our first example. How many pounds of dog food, that is 50% rice, must be mixed with 400 pounds of dog food, that is 80% rice, to make a dog food that is 75% rice? So when we use the seesaw method, what we're proving is that no matter how big two different things are, right, no matter how big two different things are, as long as they are sitting the appropriate distance from the fulcrum, they can still keep that seesaw balanced. So remember, it's all about your quantity times your distance, and your quantity times your distance. So that's how the seesaw method works. So let's take a look here. I have a 50% rice dog food mixture and I have an 80% rice dog food mixture. So I like to put my lower percentage on the left, but it does not matter where you put it. So I have a 50% mixture, I have an 80% mixture, and I have a goal of a 75% mixture. And the only other information I'm given is the quantity of the 80% rice. So I like to put my percentages on top of the seesaw and my quantity right below it. Here, 400 pounds of the 80% rice. And the question is, how many pounds of 50% rice do I need? So this is my unknown. So in one section here, you're always going to have an unknown, or possibly two sections may be unknown if they have a relationship to each other. So remember, to balance a seesaw, the fulcrum represents the equal sign, and the quantity times the distance to the goal is the algebraic expression you're going to use on each side. So for here, the distance to the goal is 25%, right? 75 take away 50 is 25%. So this is my distance, and these numbers are no longer needed for here. So my 80%, the goal is 5%, right, away, 5%. And distance is always positive. So I'm not going to read from left to right and say 75 take away 80 is negative 5, because you can't have a negative distance. So we're always using the absolute value here of a distance of 25, a distance of 5, and our quantities of x and 400. So here we go. Let's set up our equation. Remember, the fulcrum represents the equal sign. So we have our quantity times our distance, right? These numbers are no longer needed. Our quantity times our distance is equal to our quantity times our distance. And so we're going to get 25x is equal to, what is that, 2,000. And then, in order to get x by itself, we're going to divide both sides by 25. And we're going to get 80. So 25 on both sides, and x is equal to 80, and then we go back to find out, what does x represent? Oh, it represents a quantity, so that's 80 pounds. So we need 80 pounds of the 50% rice mixture in order to create a 70% rice mixture. Let's take a look at another example here. Mary has some 1% fat milk and 4% fat milk, and she wants to make 15 cups of 2% fat milk by mixing them together. All right, so we've got a mixture here. We have a lower percentage, we have a higher percentage, and then we have our in-between measure. And it tells us that she wants to make 15 cups, but she doesn't tell us what the quantity of each item is, only what the total is. So the total is 15 cups. Now remember, if this was 7 cups, then we know logically that would be 8 cups, because 7 plus 8 makes 15. And if this was 6 cups, how would you logically find this one over here? Well, if this was 6, just pretend, using some simpler numbers, if this was 6, we would take it away from our total, and that's how we would find our missing number. So if I know the total is 15, then one of these values is unknown, and the other value can be found by subtracting that unknown from the total. So it looks like both of our sides have an algebraic expression. So let's set up our equation. So the distance to the goal is 1. The distance to the goal is 2. So the quantity times the distance, right? The quantity times the distance. The quantity times the distance in any order. And that gives me x is equal to 30 minus 2x. I add 2x to both sides. I get 3x is equal to 30. I'm running out of room, so I'm going to take the liberty here of saying divide by 3, divide by 3. And I get 10. But that only tells me that I need 10 cups, right? I need 10 cups of the 1% milk. 10 cups of the 1% fat milk. And that means 15 take away 10 would be 5 cups of the 4% fat milk. So don't forget to actually answer the question, which is how much of each kind should she use. So 10 cups of the 1% and 5 cups of the 4%. All right, let's take a look at our final question here. 10 quarts of pure apple juice. So pure apple juice is 100% apple juice. So I know that's got to be my higher percentage, right? 10 quarts, so there's 10 quarts. 10 quarts of pure apple juice is added to 90 quarts, so that's a quantity. 90 quarts of a fruit juice that is 10% apple juice. What is the percent concentration of apple juice in the resulting mixture? Oh, the mixture's here, and they're asking me, what is that? So that is our unknown. So let's see what we've got here. We know we've got an equal sign for the fulcrum, but we have to multiply our quantity times our distance, and I don't know what the distance is because I don't know what the goal is. I know it's somewhere between 10 and 100, but I don't know what it is. But let's pretend this was a 40. Let's just pretend. If the goal was 40, what math would I be doing to figure out the distance? Well, I would be saying, well, I already have 10, and I need 40, so I'm going to take 10 away, right? My arithmetic would be 40, take away 10. That's how I would get my imaginary 30 here. Now, we don't know that the goal is 40, but the arithmetic would still be the same. So this number, take away that number, is the distance to the goal. Now let's take a look at the higher end. Well, again, let's go back to solving our simpler problem here. Let's pretend the goal is 40. Well, my current amount is 100. So I know mathematically you're logically figured this out, but what's the actual arithmetic? Am I doing 40 take away 100 or 100 take away 40? So since distance is always positive, we're going to set this up as the larger value take away the smaller value. So it's 100 take away the goal. So like I said, we don't know that the goal is 40, but if we did, it would be 100 take away the goal. So now we have two algebraic expressions. And notice how they're set up. One has the goal as the first value, and one has the goal as the second value. So where you're starting is important. If you're starting at the lower strength, then that gets subtracted from the goal. But if you're starting with the stronger strength, then that the goal gets subtracted from it. So again, quantity times distance, so 90 times x minus 10 is equal to 10 times 100 minus x. And now hopefully I have enough space to do all this. Maybe if I just drag it up a little bit here, I can fit it all in. So 90x minus 900 equals 1,000, right, minus 10x. So I'm going to add 10x to both sides. And that gives me 100x minus 900 equals 1,000. And I'm going to add 900 to both sides. Whoops, that's a 900. A little messy there. 100x is equal to 1,900. So we're going to divide by 100. This isn't so bad. I don't even need a calculator here. So x, which is our mixture strength, is going to be equal to 19%. So this type of problem might be new for some of you. So make sure you're taking a good look at how you're setting up your unknown distances and that your x's are in the right place. All right, I think you're ready to try some of these examples on your own. So that concludes the examples for the mixture word problems, and you're going to try the ones in your worksheet on your own. You can unpause the video to check your solutions when you're done. So let's take a look at the solutions to the worksheet.